again, a resume of the rseat from the unboxing. Finally got into it, very well packaged. Very, very well packaged. I don't think I've ever had something so bloody awkward. Wheel deck and seat plate. Yeah, very nice. Very, very nice. Let's put these at this end. And filmed here. This looks like the feet for the nose. Yeah, that's feet for the nose. I think in the first package I took out was the keyboard and mouse trays. Oh, there's a number 3 written on there. Right there. Right. That's the pedal deck piece. So let's finally get a look at the seat. I'm going to go back to the karambit because this one looks like it's going to be a little awkward. That's the seat. Extra protection with the foam. On the corners of the seat. One of the things I was thinking is that the seat piece and the wheel deck part, the nose half, can be separated so it could be used as a gaming chair. According to Inside Some Racing, it's very comfortable. I'll find out for myself. See if I can doze off in it. The bubble wrap is stitched together. Oh well. headrest, cushiony. That's a very nice looking seat. There's Velcro. And I've actually taken it off. There's a Why would a spring or something under there? Yeah, there's no stickiness on the back of that Velcro. Huh, cut my hand. Oh well. Grab a pillow to protect. Do not want scratches. Where do we get into it? I think this side. Oh, That is interesting. Okay. That's the arm for the keyboard and mouse tray. Hopefully that'll be lockable in position. That's the keyboard and mouse tray itself. It's got a cloth over the top. Not fully glued on, but that's not a problem. I thought it was just metal, but there is actually a cloth. Very nice. Very nice indeed. What else was there? Nothing. No, the pedal deck and a lot of rubbish. Do not entirely think I'll be needing that anymore.